Watch how I make niggas quit just by fucking taking them down. I don't even got a box. Let's see. Touch the sky, but you ain't got shit on me. Cause I'm on what? Top of the world. I'm on top of the world. A level 16, he's one of them temp niggas. Wow. Burn down my house and build it up again. Tell him I burn it down twice just for the.
It's a flyweight matchup between Demetrius Johnson and Henry the Messenger Cejudo.
Cejudo. This nigga, he 5'3 in real life. This nigga short as fuck.
Ready?
Both these niggas, they flyweight.
Alright, so here we are back at the pool here in the tri-state area, Newark, New Jersey. Big UFC live event coming up here tonight. And this venue doesn't get as many shows as it used to because of the New York legislation, but certainly they come out when the UFC's in time.
Before the UFC was able to
compete in Madison
Square Garden, we went to the Prudential Center. It was as close as we could get, and the fans always showed up. It is a great arena, and they place.
He's fucking doing the leg kick.
So both guys landing at will here. Good action early. All right, so he continues to use his jab effectively here, DC. He gets that hand to the target.
Oh, my God.
Just right away and blasts the jab after jab after jab. He's a phenomenal boxer with a vast understanding of fighting behind that
educated
jab.
Imagine this up.
You wonder if the offensive fighter is going to start to get frustrated here. Most skipped on all the
shots. Oh, my God.
They're getting blocked because he's fighting one of the best defensive fighters in the UFC.
Bro, I can't. He just spam. I'm letting him with his stamina,
bro. In my numbers for you now, 29 total spamming. Strikes have landed for Henry Cejudo. Oh, how about this kicking game on full display tonight?
Kick back to back.
Imagine slamming this shit.
Who is it? I can't hear. I can't hear because it's coming on my TV.
2 minutes have expired in our opening round. Well, looks as though his leg is hurt here. You can even see him limping a little bit. Back and forth we go.
Come on. Come on. Keep going.
Trying to establish that jab once again. Going to the leg kick.
Yo,
now, and it's there. Nice job by Cejudo. He continues to evolve as a striker.
Big power punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Switching stances here.
Hey, I got his ass now. I got his ass now.
He flips him over the top. What a huge takedown.
I mean, do I survive that or am I read my last round?
Absolutely not. It's over. It's over now.
Pretty good ground and pound by him here. He told us on Thursday he needed to be more effective in these situations. Certainly effective tonight.
Many people have gone away from the style of fighting. This man has embraced it. And you are seeing why he's one of the best that we've seen do it in a long time.
It's lagging now. How's he blocking my strikes on no block?
Again, strong work here by Johnson.
He's not getting up.
Oh, nice job here staying busy off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom.
How?
Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now, the ground and pound starts. Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Back mount now. Oh. Round two next.
Fuck off, man.
All right, second round now underway. I'm no analyst, but a little bit of a feeling out process there in round one.
And that's a part of being in the octagon with someone that's so skilled. You cannot just go after
them. Let me start off the round, people.
Both young men are trying to find the right moment to
Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. He's doing a great job of mixing everything up. Look at him working at trying to set the lead. He needs to start looking to finish.
Oh, he's going to slam
him. He got that single leg. He lifted him in the air and put him down.
That is some serious power pick up another man and promptly put him in his place. Big opportunity now for him here on the ground. Well, these are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold him.
Know when to hold him. Yep, absolutely.
Well, he's up, but he is hurting for... Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Big left.
Oh, nice. Nice.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Man, as he landed up.
Bro,
fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish his fight. Oh, got it.
A couple of hammer fists now.
Let's go. Oh my god.
Oh, reversal.
No. Oh,
what a way to switch the position. Fantastic movement by the bottom fighter.
Back up.
Under 2 minutes now to go in round two.
Let's go. This fight's over.
He's gonna start
this fight's over.
To try to attack a rear naked
fight's over.
That's exactly
fight's
what he's
over,
doing.
Nigga.
Job of relaxing, not panicking, because he's getting choked.
Yeah, this fight, oh, he's gonna break out. This game's ass. He has no stamina.
Wow. Side control now, and certainly I would think more offensive options for the bottom fighter than in half guard.
Absolutely.
Can wrestle
now, because now you can just start to get away. You can just go to a wrestler stand up, get to your knees. Post your hands. Don't allow him to get his hooks in. Right? Really be aware of the hooks. But get to your handstand.
Get him off me, ref. What the hell are you doing?
Escape. But it's so much more free-flowing than the half guard in the side control. Because all you need to do is just get the opponent's body up because his legs are just free to move. His legs.
Oh!
Dude's hurt. Throws him off. Go get him.
Side control now.
Oh my god, y'all watching this shit? He's whooping my ass.
Entertaining scrap so far. Alright, so back-to-back entertaining rounds. We'll see how it goes in this round. We'll see which corner sort of maximize those 60 seconds on the strip.
This is what happens when you get two very skilled, very evenly matched fighters coming together. Nobody has really taking a lead in this fight. Let's see who does it when it comes next.
Oh!
He's hurt. He's hurt bad.
Oh my god.
Back to the feet. Visibly limping here.
Oh, he's got his back. Oh,
yeah. Bro, this is not even funny, man.
Good movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground tonight.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent in every transition.
Keep the fuck off me.
Outstanding pressure from top position here by Cejudo. 3 minutes now to go to decide this one. All right, late in the fight now, he needs a finish or he's going to lose this fight tonight. We'll see if he goes for it.
I mean, he's got to pull out all the stops. There is no more...
Whoa! And just like that, the fight is over.
Oh!
Yeah, that right there is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge win for Shabandi.
Nigga's ass. Keep my leg the whole fight, and I had the low block, and he fucked me up. Karan said I'm a bot. Hey, Karan, you ugly. I clapped you in that Fortnite yesterday. Magic getting clapped by the goat in Fortnite. You're ass, dude. Look, I beat this dude 3 times already. They keep matching me up with him. I know he don't want to play me. He gonna pick that creative fighter with that ugly ass face. Imagine. Oh, watch you pick this creative fighter with that big old head. Look, I knew it.
I was watching 2 CPU fight.
You
might have knew me, but you do not know me. It's ancient. Wait,
a lot of you copping designer and flex it. It costs you an arm and a thigh. What do you say? Imagine saying, imagine saying that. Look at me. Look at this dude I'm fighting against. I beat him 3 times already, and they keep matching me up with him.
Ready. Alright, so here we go with round one. Seems to be a situation in which he wants to do everything in his power to keep this fight on the feet.
He appears to have a lot of advantages at distance. Okay, okay. We'll see if he can get it done tonight.
Yes, he has all the advantages because we don't see many specialists anymore in the UFC. Guys can generally do everything, but this guy
has. Every time I take him down, he quit, bro.
He wants to get the fight to the ground and start to weave his web of traps to try and find a submission. This striker needs to maintain his space. He needs to make sure he is not on the ground. Avoid it at all costs.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick. And with authority, goes to the judo throw right into side control.
He's inside control. He's got a ton of options.
All right, side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
All right, DC, half guard position. Ow, you've done a lot of good work at this spot in your career.
Oh, man, I love this position. And you see this fighter today loves it too. It is the most secure position in fighting. You get an underhook on one side, you get a half guard on the other, and then you just go to work. It's the safest position, especially for a wrestler.
Get him off me. Fuck no. Try to choke me.
Before Neighbors was a person, emoji happy tears.
Yo, the ref don't get this nigga off me, bro.
I need you to get control of his wrist.
Get off my fucking back.
And the referee brings the fight back to his feet. No surprise there. Needed to see more action.
Look, he quit. He's ass because he can't get his way on the ground. He sucks. So ass. No, he sucks. He used a creative fighter. And I still be beating him. Bro, I'm 3-0 against that nigga. And it pit me against him again. Look, he quit immediately. Come on now. Niggas know my body. Nigga quit immediately. Look, pin me against him again. He quit, and bro. I need some comp. Let me go to ranked. I'm gonna go to ranked, man. I need some fucking confidence, bitch.
like Michael. Wanna know why nobody likes you? They're scared cause there's nobody like you.
Crap. Only cause you be flyweight ass nigga. And this nigga is a sweatball, he's gonna whoop my ass. What a creative fighter. Okay, buddy. Yeah, right.
UConn. Emoji happy tears. 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 Emoji happy tears.
Jersey, the Prudential Center. You know, some people call this the armpit of America. I'm having a good time. I don't know.
It's a beautiful place and a beautiful arena. And the fans here are ready to explode the moment something exciting happens.
Just misses with the right. A little single collar tie there. Oh, nice punch there by Cejudo. He continues to evolve as a striker. Nice jab. Follows it up with a nice right hand. These guys throwing early.
Oh, yeah,
well, he told us on Thursday, you don't get paid to fight 15 minutes to that end. Early takedown is there.
His ideal fight is a grind. As ugly as he can make it, it's better for him. And with this early takedown, he ensures that he can start to wear the gas tank for a long time.
And they the both talk as he takes it down. Now we'll see what he can do.
Right into side control.
All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long.
And this pussy loud. All
right, close guard now.
What's up, man?
Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent. Nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do.
He's gonna start looking.
Looks like he's transitioning an arm guard.
He cannot stay in the guard of these great jiu-jitsu guys.
He's tapped. He definitely about to tap.
Attack an arm guard.
He might get a finish here. Just be a matter of time.
What I tell you, nigga, I need some comp. This nigga about to tap right now. I need some fucking comp in this bitch. I need some comp, nigga. Get him out of here. What a creative fighter. Come on, man. Stop it. Bye-bye.
How about it? Gets the win by submission. Beautifully executed.
Come on, let's link. Can do what I do. Come on, man.
Who won this round?
What'd he say? He said, who won? He gay. Karan gay. He said, who won this WAP? He gay as hell. He gay. Come on, let's link. Can do what I do. If I lose, I'm gonna get on 2K. How about that? I just put a nigga in an arm bar for the iPhone 8. Karan said, who want this WAP? He gay as hell. Imagine being gay in 2020. Imagine saying you got your dick sucked on the bus by a dude. Nigga, you said it. Come on, Les Lane, can't do what I do. I'm gonna beat it up with no hands. I'm gonna use Henry Cejudo again. Peace out. He's gonna leave. Peace out. Hey, so Godzilla, I ain't chicken. I'm just.
Alright, coming up next, it's a UFC flyweight division matchup.
I put WAP on live for 10 cents.
I'll pick my pop. My WAP on live for 10 cents. He gay. Come on, let's win. Come on, Oh, yeah. We're going to start this round off right now.
What a fantastic takedown. Welcome to the Cormier Express. Well, he is grounding, he is pounding, and now he's working the body to great effect. Nice job by Cejudo. Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. Changes his stance. Oh, really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC. Oh, lands a stiff punch there. Nice connection.
Oh, nice land.
Oh, slips and rips.
I'm missing each of the body.
Man, he's timing the shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop it. John, stop.
And they are exchanging leather early. Oh, and he gets tagged. Beautiful combination there. And I'm not sure how many more of those power shots he can take, honestly.
The night is almost over. If you can get hit with punches like this, you are going to sleep. Nice combination. Watch knees to the body.
So just over 20 total strikes. Mm-hmm. Now landed for Davison Figueiredo.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he's got his back. Now he's got to start trying to drag him to the ground. Then he can look for submission.
How?
Well, a lot of people think he might have the best jab in this division, certainly using it effectively here.
I mean, one of the best jabs in the world across all combat.
Oh, and the ankle kick to get him down. Let's see if he can.
5 minutes to get this here before, man.
Let's see how he advances in this position.
You see how comfortable Cejudo is in the pocket. Wasn't necessarily the case when he made his UFC debut back in 2014.
Great punch.
Oh my god.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. Big elbow. Oh man, this ground and pound is good. Probably.
Yo, I'm denying his takedown. I'm denying his transitions, and it's barely letting him get him.
He's allowing it. Oh, and he hip tosses him to the mat.
Let's go. Nigga's not fucking
with me. He's gonna try to control him, then find a submission.
Oh wow, that happened quickly as the fighter reverses position there on the ground.
Unbelievable position change. Wow, what a transition.
Now drops inside that closed guard, DC.
Full guard. Let's see how patient he is as he attacks a submission or big.
No, no, sir.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
All right, so pretty good damage here with the ground and pound. Nothing superficial about these strikes. They are intending
I'm denying that. What the fuck?
He's landing very accurately, and he's landing to get damage off.
Nice hammer fist. Oh, useful strike on the ground.
Wet
that
ass
was.
Pussy. Wet ass pussy.
All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. We had a knockdown there, but not a knockout.
No, it wasn't a knockout, but you can't take those shots. That big punch landed, and it sat him down. If he gets hit with another one of those, it might be good night, Irene.
Where's guard IQ in the game? Yes. You sell my niggas. No, you sell. You don't look past. There's I in your basket. There's I in the way you spell basketball, ain't it?
Round two on the way.
Oh, hold on.
Oh, man, he's got his back.
That's pretty boring.
He needs to isolate a hip to try to peel those hands and break that lock. Again, back into this position. Look at the control of the posture as they land that knee. Nice punch.
Timing his shots nice in here, champ.
He's doing a great job.
Today I get my bread turkey. Today I quit playing.
And using a lot of diverse strikes.
Now he's got the Muay Thai plunk. And they separate. 68 total strikes. And now
imagine.
Davison
nigga, I'm
in terms of the accuracy, strong, now landing at a 58% clip against Henry Cejudo.
Okay. My body control is immaculate.
And now he's got that Thai plunk. Well, if you like Muay Thai striking, this might be your moment in this fight as he gets the title.
This is a massive moment for this fighter. He's a great Muay Thai fighter. Look for him to go knee-knee and then try to land a big one to the head.
Maybe they ain't ever be coming here. We'd be weird.
Good shot by him there. to raise the guard and protect his head.
He's doing a good job of keeping the guard high, blocking his head, making sure he's not taking those damaging strikes.
Thank you for me.
Oh, man, he got him back. He's gonna drag him to the floor, into his world.
Nigga, he had two all day, because last time I was hitting more than two.
Big shots exchanged in the pocket there. Oh, single collar tie here.
You're not shooting better than me at home. Both times you went to home. Yeah, three all days at home.
His opponents are on Beat Street.
I'm not talking to you.
So bad. I don't know what he's gonna do to stay in this fight.
That one appeared to stun him.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Dude picked the champion, and I'm frying him. Come on now.
Oh, big left hook there. Man, as he landed the high ball strikes here in
definitely
round two. Definitely picking up the pace after round one. So he got the message from the corner. And
he needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent.
Nobody ever gets finished.
I just got to finish. Somebody used Brian Ortega and I got to finish on the first time I'm not going to get through. Look at that. Come on now. He picked the champion and I knocked him out. And he at level 36. Stop playing with me, bro. Stop playing with me.
Just a
fucking goat, nigga.
Just the
fucking
way he found the opening and capitalized on
Patrick
it to the utmost extent.
Oh, what happened?
You know how, like, he either calls out a lot or don't show up?
Mm-hmm.
He actually called out, like, a week before, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, the days that he usually works were given to somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
Then he called, like, 2 days ago, the day before yesterday, and was like, actually, can you put me marking out for these days? And she marked them off, but she couldn't give them back the hours that other people are down for, right?
Mm-hmm.
So basically, he was out for a whole week.
Mm-hmm.
So he went on Facebook.
Hell, I'm not
on me. Hell of shit. Yo, this video is funny as hell. He went on Facebook talking mad shit, bro.
Tell him I put that WAP on me. He gay. Crying gay. He said, tell him I put that WAP on me.
Yeah.
They said, what would y'all do if y'all was in a room by themselves, by yourself?
I would never allow that.
They said, him and you in the room, lights off, movie on.
It is a championship fight between Henry Cejudo and TJ.
He said, fifth grade, you and him back at the bus.
Is this right?
That's what they were. Yeah, you can pick creative players. They be cheating, bro. Level 57. That's not a creative player. I'm tripping.
Yeah, you would think that he would just avoid grappling at all costs.
But no way. Imagine.
What do you mean, no way? I just pulled my hair off so I can watch it.
Fight with their ego and force.
No way. Oh, lordy, lordy, lord.
Unable to connect with the right. Man, is he timing his shots well?
He said you was ugly as hell taking finger pictures.
I mean, he is so sharp.
Oh, my lordy, lordy, lord.
He's also keeping very busy.
Hell yeah, I got it on my phone.
Fight, and I'm not sure these fighters realize that we got 3 or 5 rounds
tonight. No feeling out process. Uh-oh,
you
got to
get taken down a little bit.
The moment this fight started, these two gentlemen were ready to knock each other's heads off.
You got to get taken down. I'm on his back. I know he bad. Just drained all his... What?
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent very bad.
Big combination here of ground and pound strikes. Nice work by Cejudo. Just misses there with the left. Oh, big left hook there.
Clinch position. Look for a lot of different takedown attempts. A lot of level changes. Really trying to empty the gas tank of the opponent.
So as we pull up some numbers, 29 total strikes have landed for Henry Cejudo.
Bro, get the fuck out the mic.
Single collar tie there. All right, so a nice shot there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be, and if you do that, most.
Oh my God! Look at the knockout animation of the guy. Oh, didn't let me knock him out.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Get the fuck out of here.
Couple hammer fists there for good measure.
I know, I'm just saying, I'm just saying. This, look, he can't be. Niggas not fuck with me in this UFC shit.
Oh, he postured up there.
Look at him. Trying to get up.
Now, the grounded pound starts.
Goes upstairs for an elbow.
Imagine throwing an elbow at me with no stamina.
Anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire.
No way he could put my back like that.
What a way to switch the position.
Oh, you
want to
get up.
Fantastic movement by the bottom fighter.
You want to get up? Get the fuck down. The fuck down.
Nicely done there as he forces.
But who wants this work, nigga? I'm a fucking ghost. Whoever watching the stream, y'all seen that shit. First round knockout, man. Stop playing me.
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with
who's next?
He wanted to make sure he kept the judges out of the equation.
Who's next? And he's a level 56, nigga. The sweat ball. Come on now. Nigga. Come on now. And I'm a champion now. Stop playing. Macaroni in a pot. That's some wet. That's some wet. He only landed 26 strikes. I landed 63. Oh, I'm gonna put my aiming back on, bro. I've been greening with my pain beef. Oh, they matched me up with this dude again. I'm dead. He gonna whoop my ass. I'm picking Harry Sahut up before he gets home. Stupid. I'll be on 2K after this game. You already know he gonna beat me. Crying gay, he said, period, bitch. God, why crying? What's good with that 2K, man? That 2K21.
More BM.
Man, I'm about to DoorDash today.
Coming up next, a UFC flyweight division
later.
Action.
In getting an RCT.
I'm getting it. Net. NRCT. What does NRCT mean? Next gen. Next gen.
It is now underway on one side with the fighter who does
oh, yeah, dude.
Oh
yeah, I'm in them scans this game. I'm in them scans this game, Zay. He not beating me. What the nigga mean?
Oh, straight right. Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes. Nice punch land.
Oh, really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC. Couple of chins here being tested early. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Nigga always trying to 1v1 somebody.
Nice kick with the right hand. Always hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got a pressure.
Yeah, I told you I'm going to get on when I lose.
Back to the feet. Now goes in and...
Can I defend my title? Oh, I got it.
Nice hammer fist. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these
all right,
type
bro,
of
this
transitions and scrambles on the ground.
I love to come home is really entertaining.
Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transitions.
He is not staying in one place on the ground, and that's very important.
All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Far working out of side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you gotta be
careful.
The
ref don't get this nigga off me, bro.
Back mount now. Just over 2 minutes to go in the round.
Get him off my back.
I love watching this guy move on the ground. Another nice transition there.
Such a high-level grappler. You don't see that very often.
Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do next.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
That's how he beat me last fight. Just staying on top of me the whole fucking round.
Total strikes have landed for Henry Cejudo.
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. We'll finish this fight.
Oh, big left. Both guys landing with conviction now. Oh! All right, side control now. All right, inside his opponent's guard here, DC. You don't want to play around here too long.
No, you got to either have two hands in or two hands out. Our guys start to attack triangle.
Lands the grounded pound strike. Horn sounds for the end of round one.
I had to run that round.
All right, let's check out some of the action, DC, and how about
I landed 53 strikes, he landed 35. And I knocked him down like three times. Niggas know my fucking body. $100 games, UFC 4, man.
All right, round two.
He loaded up there on that high kick.
Oh! Nigga, you gay, baby. Nigga, look at this. Who's watching this? Like, come on now.
All right, rubber guard for him now, DC. We haven't seen you lean on this in the octagon.
No, I can't get those legs up there. Come on, man. Look at these tree trunks. They don't go up around nobody's shoulders. I like to keep my feet on the ground, and I like to grind. That's what I'm known for. But this guy,
looking for a guillotine.
Just to get countered. I don't even know why you put me in a guillotine. It's UFC 4.
Bottom fighter trying to control. And he's out. Triangle looks pretty tight, DC. I'm no Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, but maybe not good here.
No, it looks like it's getting in deep. Oh!
Well, he's got one hand in, one hand out. Now you're looking for defensively. Posturing up now, and he's out. Under 3 minutes now to go in round two. Scramble. Oh, it looks like he's transitioning an armbar.
You cannot stay in the guard of these great jiu-jitsu guys.
Yo, get this man's off me, bro. They cheating right now. They let him put me in like 30 submissions. Oh, yeah.
Armor's been isolated, but he picks him up and slams him down.
He lifted him through the air, slammed him on his back, and moved right into side control to get out of danger.
Beautiful job to not just turn defense into offense, but also to end up in a dominant position. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of...
Now he chased the triangle.
And this could be trouble here. Looks like it's pretty tight. He's trying to work his head out of harm's way.
Look at this. Are y'all not seeing this? Bro, look what he keep doing, bro. That's not fair.
Oh, he's got one hand in, one hand out. I'm gonna beat him. If
I get out of this, I'm beating him. I'm gonna knock him out.
You have no choice but to tap.
But yeah, I'm slamming him right now. It's over.
Just when it looked like he might get submitted, he slams his opponent down with authority as the tide turns.
What is this camera angle?
Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent. All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
All right, we'll see how he chooses to defend here. Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round.
He landed six strikes. All he did was attempt submission.
So
he
back
sucks.
To the stool. Mentally, probably not in a great place here. So here we go, third and final round.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Yeah, who don't get finishes like that? Stop playing on me, bro. Stop playing on me. I'm the GOAT. Stop playing on me. I'm the GOAT.
Not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter here tonight.
That's why I'm a champion in UFC 4. Pick Lewis Smoker, you must want to lose. Oh my god, look who he picks. A creative fighter. Get him.
Get on 2K.
Get on 2K, a glass bar. I'm gonna invite you to a party and I'm gonna get on 2K whenever I lose. I'm defending my championship right now. I ain't lost yet.
Ready to fight?
Yes, I'm ready to fight. Nigga, let's get it.
Alright, so here we go. Round one of this highly anticipated tilt between the strong striker and the decorated grappler.
I ain't gonna lie, I'm gonna lose this game because he got a creative fighter. Niggas be cheating. In this ranked match, how can you use creative fighters in ranked?
The striker will try to lead with his punches and his kicks, and the grappler will try to time a takedown. Time a clinch position so he can start to work towards a lot of those great judo throws that he possesses. Once on the ground, he is in his realm and will start to chase submissions.
Oh, he told you off the top he had the reach advantage. Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh! Oh, straight right! Oh, look at him land another jab there. He's certainly using that weapon effectively here tonight.
The most effective weapon in all of boxing, in all of combat.
Man.
He's hurt. Serve him up. Go get
knee
him.
To the body. Oh! Strong defense there to block the shot. Both of these guys going all out. High action fight here. The Olympic gold medalist Cejudo gets stung by that leg kick.
Straight punch lands.
Nice 1-2 there. Oh, he's wearing it now, bleeding from his cheeks. Man, it's almost like
he needs to start.
Oh!
Yo, how?
Thank you. right, so he continues to land that jab. His opponent said he was ready for it, but doesn't appear to be.
You're not ready until you're in there. You can watch all the film you want. You can spar as much as you want, but until you feel a guy with a fast jab like this, you don't understand the precision of that punch. Nice punch lands over the top.
Both fighters throwing heat now. Total strikes have landed for Henry Cejudo.
What a
double leg! All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long.
How? I'm denying that.
It's the elbow there.
He's putting him in exactly the position he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here, and he understands, being a veteran of so many fights,
make him go off,
that man. As long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Looks like he might attempt the guillotine now.
I'm tripping around over.
This fight, folks, you see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round, saved by the bell. So back to the start.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Round two is underway. Big elbow there, Lance.
What?
Well, you saw his record.
Oh. All I got is one, bro.
Back to the feet.
Where's your mask at?
Where's well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together.
Wow, actually got the takedown.
All right, so a near perfect entry there, and finally he gets his first takedown of the fight, and they say if at first you don't succeed. Try again. He's able to get him down.
Persistence pays. And that's what we saw with this young man. Over and over, he shot for takedowns. He tried to mix it up. He got defended. But eventually, he got it done. Now, what does he do with this top control?
Oh, big combination of ground and pound strikes here, DC. This could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you got to be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need a controlled posture.
Goes working off that jab again. How's your jab?
I mean, the jab's nice. I love throwing the jab. But you realize that as MMA evolves, guys will start to fight behind a very educated jab. It's just like boxing. The most thrown punch, and the first one you learn is a jab.
Right.
And in MMA, guys are starting to take that same approach because it is such an effective weapon.
Cejudo gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there.
Keep throwing elbows.
Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked, the hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming.
Battle for position here. The Olympic gold medalist Cejudo gets it. Smell that punch right there.
It's one thing to land a hard shot. It's another thing completely to land a perfect shot. And that was a perfect shot.
Working off his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Well, he's more than content to work off of his back, DC, where he has been a magician.
This nigga lag. I'm getting off after this. Bro.
Man, that cut is just getting worse by the minute.
Bro, this nigga lagging, bro. I can't.
Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every... Oh! He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Man, you can literally be beating a creative fighter the whole fight, and they get one move on you, it's over.
Now he's on top of him looking for a
Like, this shit is stale. I was beating him the whole time.
So aggressive with his onslaught that ultimately appeared as though the outcome was an eventuality. So if you're
how many times I gotta knock him down to win a fight? He knocked me down once and then win. This is trash. Look at his ass cheek.
Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer.
If I was to make a creative fighter, I would never lose. I'm about to rip for it tonight. I outstruck him 120 to 93. He had one knockdown, and he won the fight. Like, come on, bro.